9 nights ago, I stood right here on this show and I got pretty worked up about what is happening with the NFL, its players, protests, and the national anthem. I said I thought the players' message was getting hijacked. That's the word I used, hijacked. And I used that word because I felt the intent, the reason for the protest was being misinterpreted and spun by so many in this country. Suddenly, taking a knee to spotlight police brutality of black people became unpatriotic, disrespect for the military and the country. The narrative became hijacked. And that night, a man named Kelly contacted me, a man with a long list of military service in his family. He was hurt by what I said, hurt by players not standing for the national anthem. We talked a little bit that night, and I invited him here today to talk a bit more.
You got me nervous now.
It's okay. I'm nervous too, to be fair.
The thing that got me was when you said hijacked. Mm. And I think the anthem was hijacked. Mm. So we both have, you know, completely opposite sides of what we saw or what we felt about it. And we come from different backgrounds. I was always brought up that the flag and the national anthem is something that you hold in high regard. And if you're going to have a protest, that's not the time. You want to do it before or after. Or if you want a positive result, do something positive.
They were never trying to disrespect your family, that flag, this country. They were trying to talk about social inequalities.
Intentions can be one thing, but results can be another. They were doing something to bring awareness about the inequality, which is all well and fine, but for those of us who are taught that you stand and put your hand over your heart and look at the flag during the anthem, it was disrespectful to us.
It doesn't seem like especially people of color are given space to do anything without it being inconvenient to other people. Don't do it during the national anthem. Don't shut down the highway. Don't go to the lunch counter and shut that down. Don't march across the Pettus Bridge in Selma. What are black people supposed to do to get people's attention about racial inequality and social injustices?
But is just getting attention doing anything? What's the end result of their attention? Is there a better way, a more positive way, where people are gonna go, we'd like to help?
Eric Reed plays for the San Francisco 49ers, Colin Kaepernick's friend. He's been with him since the beginning on this. And here's what he said. We chose to kneel because it's a respectful gesture. I remember thinking our posture was like a flag flown at half-mast to mark a tragedy. It baffles me that our protest is still being misconstrued as disrespectful to the country, the flag, and military personnel. We chose it because it is exactly the opposite. It has always been my understanding that the brave women and men who fought and died for our country did so to ensure that we could live in a fair and free society, which includes the right to speak out and protest.
The media coverage that I saw said nothing about that. Apparently, sometimes it does have to ruffle some feathers. What you read to me, I had never heard.
What if you live in a country where you as a person are still not treated equally, like a person of color?
There is no quick answer for anything. There's trying to have understanding and improvements.
Because you feel the way you do about the anthem and the flag does not make you a racist. Because I feel the way I do about these players doing what they do does not make me un-American, right?
That's so true.
I'm listening. So is Rena, so is Chris. We are, especially when we disagree respectfully. I want to thank Kelly for his courage to sit with me this afternoon. We'll be right back.